So these discussions are difficult.
The next question is from Chris Sorensen. Chris? Do you want to ask the room?
I was just wondering, once you use on legalizing marijuana in a state of New York, because 16 states have already done it, so it's actually the state, and it does have some
The question is about how I feel about legalizing medical marijuana in New York. That would be a New York issue, and you'd have to ask Senator DeFrancisco, one of our assemblymen, as to, because that would be their vote. It would be my vote. Thank you.
If you were in the state legislature, would you support it?
Here's a question from Cassandra Hoffman. Where's Cassandra? Is she here? No? Okay, I'll ask a question. If Planned Parenthood is cut, how do you propose to handle problems like teen pregnancy, unwanted pregnancies, the low-income families that cannot afford birth control or a child?
Planned Parenthood has probably, their total assets is about $1 billion. Planned Parenthood doesn't need government money. They're just fine doing it on their own. And I think I mentioned earlier about funding and a lot of the funding that we, whether it's oil companies or, we've got to get away from that. I think Planned Parenthood they do what they do in the community. They have resources. It would be interesting to find out what they pay their CEO. I think that they can live just fine without government money. And you know, that isn't me. That is the American people saying, we don't want to be in the business of funding Planned Parenthood. That's a national, even people who are in favor of abortion are not comfortable with the federal government funding abortion. So across the country, the majority of people, they don't want their tax dollars funding abortion. And it, for an organization like Planned Parenthood, who had billions and millions of dollars, they don't need that money. So I appreciate you asking a question for someone who's not here. Thank you.
She may be here. Scott, I think, is your name Scott Lund?
Yes. Good morning, or good afternoon. First of all, thank you for your service. My question has to do with redistricting. And I don't know if that's been certified yet. Maybe you can clarify that. But to my point, my question is, if in fact redistricting tends to be swayed towards the socialistic Southwest of us, would in fact you change districts to be close by, but yet still engage and still run? So where's your plan at? Where's your future at?
Thank you for the question. The question is about redistricting, and that's a great question. We're all sitting. I don't know. Maybe Bill Carey has an inside scoop here. To the best of our understanding, last Thursday, the legislature's ability to intervene and to reach an agreement and to give the court lines expired. So the legislature is out of this. So the lines that they drew, both the Assembly and the Senate, that's done now. So what happened last Thursday was the federal magistrate, Judge Mann, she drew lines and she gave it to a three panel of judges. In Brooklyn, they had a hearing last Thursday, went all day. So we expect to hear within the next today or tomorrow, because we can, I mean, we'll start passing petitions, but you can't pass petitions, until the lines are dropped. And because we moved up the federal primary date to June 26th,